How do you know that you were held by ISIS?
Well, that's very easy. they don't hide it. I mean, they were very, very clear about it, very frank about it. First, you know, and plus, they were trying to frighten you. You know, do you know who we are? It started like we are Al-Qaeda, but not really Al-Qaeda. We are ISIS. We are a state. We're an Islamic state. They are claiming what they are.
How did they treat you?
We were detained in 8 different places. Because we moved.
They moved places. You around yeah, to 8 yeah. different places.
Yes, but we always stayed in Syria, always with ISIS. There was no other group catching us or setting us. It was ISIS from day one. We could hear the Syrian prisoners in the first places where we were detained, in the Aleppo hospital, for instance. We were in a room, but there were also some Syrian and Iraqi prisoners there. Local people who were detained for whatever reasons, because they smoked or because the girls were not wearing the proper veil or whatever, and they were beaten and tortured, and we could hear them behind the doors. We could see some of them in the corridors when we were taken to the toilets, because we had 2 hours to go to the toilets. And we could see some people lying in their blood. There were some rooms in which torture was taking place every night, and sometimes we were put in those rooms, and you could see the chains hanging, or the ropes hanging, or the iron bars and things. Yeah, and plus we had interrogations.
So you were constantly threatened. You could see what was happening to others, the torture and the barbarity.
But we were not treated that way.
You were not tortured?
No, we got some beating. It was hard and it was not...
What exactly happened to you? I know everybody tries to, you know, play down what happened, but were you beaten up?
Yeah, of course we were beaten up, but it was not every day. It's like... it's hard enough. You don't have to overplay it. It's hard enough to lose your freedom. It's hard enough to be in the hands of people who you know are killing hundreds and thousands of local Syrians, Iraqis, Libyan, Tunisian, can put bombs in our countries. They use violence as a way of ruling. They want to rule the prison the way they want to rule the organization, the way they want to rule the world, by terrorizing you, but they don't use it all the time. It's hard enough because I spent 10 months and a half, and it's really long without a book, without anything. But plus, the problem is that the guards we are always jumpy. So one day...
The guards, they're always... Yeah, freaking out.
Or one day he will come and give you a sweet for whatever reason. 2 hours later, he'll come and beat you up. And that's what makes it difficult. I mean, you never know on which foot you are going to stand and which foot you are going to stand.